Hello everyone, and welcome to the Deeply Renegade podcast. My name is Molly, also known as the Deeply Renegade, and I'd like to welcome you guys to episode 183, I think. And I'll have to check on my computer, is farther away. Yeah, it's 183. Today is Saturday, May 20th, 2017, and I'm glad you could join me today. A little bit crazy today. Whatever. I look a little bit crazy today. It's been very chill. But I figured I was gonna have to grind more coffee to make more coffee, and it's already like 4:40, so I'm like just like that. I already had a decent amount of coffee, and so may not be pretty, but I'm doing it, so it should be good. What was it? The other thing was I just, like, randomly found crap I'd forgotten about, so now I need to... I'll have a chance to talk about that, too, because I was like, oh, what is that stuff over there? Ah. So, it was full of craziness, but... this project is coming along, so this is the Find Your Fade, which is a Drea Renee pattern, and honestly, sort of like in the colors that this is showing here. So this is already a monster, like, or maybe to my elbow now, but it will stretch to my full length now. So, this is gonna legitimately be a massive shawl. And I am into the fourth color now. Making sure I'm not pulling stuff off. I'm still working the third one, though. So, I'm now into the sky blue, which is the Oakland Wild Sox. And it is very, very big and delightfully blue, at least in my eyes it is. I was having a lot of fun working with the speckle, which is an Alicia Goes Around, so here's my speckle. I still seem to have quite a lot of this, so I don't know if I'm knitting at a tighter gauge or something. And I'm breaking into this guy, which is sort of sky blues and a little bit of darker blues as well, so the darker blues are actually hanging off right now. And even like a little bit of white in here too. So this is turning out really pretty and is actually fading really well into this guy. I just have like yarn everywhere. But I'm not sure my camera can even pick up a little contrasty bits here. So I have a few more rows and then I'll be done with this speckle. But coming along. So this guy here is my fourth and center color, so after this guy's done, then it'll start, the shawl will start looking smaller. Should be nice. But in the meantime, it is quite large. So, not too shabby. Pretty mindless knitting. The lace sections are maybe a little bit less so. But there's a logic to it, so it's not terrible. I'll probably need to read my knitting the next couple of rows to make sure I'm not like randomly adding or subtracting stitches I shouldn't be. I'll have like a little bit of room to zhuzh that all out. And then I did end up starting a new project last night. Let's see if we can extract everything. Yeah, I think that's everything. So, I am taking part in the SSK Cal. And that was the correct direction, so that was good. And I am knitting a pattern that is by Amy Beth of Fast Girl Speaks. It is Seedling Dreams. And I've made one modification because I think corrugated ribbing is the most useless thing known to man. what would it be? So I just did regular ribbing and didn't do the color work in there. And I am using up my acrylic scraps. So I think I have yarn set aside to make 4 of these hats for SSK. And just use up tons and tons of my little acrylic scraps. So what I'm doing is I'm actually alternating between 4 different really small balls of yarn, which I have shoved into this one, bizarrely. I don't know, I was trying to get it all contained, because I realized I spent all this, or spent some time at Knit Night, like, putting together color combinations to use up the stuff, and that was the wrong way to pull. So we're gonna have to make this work somehow. So I didn't want to, like, lose track of them. I may have just made, like, a really, really giant mess. Oh, well. It's not, like, totally insurmountable. It just requires some careful threading of yarn. Which I think is within my capability. Like, I can see both ends, so it's probably not careful. So this is, as I mentioned, an Amy Beth pattern. It is fun to have, like, the little bits of color work, so I'm enjoying that. And, I don't know, it'd be the case for, you know, they're just parts of your stash, or like, so a few weeks ago I ended up giving away, actually, a decent amount of my acrylic, and I was looking like I could actually knit it down fairly significantly, so that was exciting to me. So I was like, woohoo! So I have this medium-ish blue color, and this might actually be from my first scarf, maybe. I might have used that a long time ago, I'm not sure. And then I have some 70-tastic white and brown variegated, and then I have a peachy one, and then this this guy here is sort of blues and yellows and greens. So with their powers combined, I think it will make for a fetching little hat, and it's fun to work this stitch pattern. I've never worked it in color before, but it does look really cute, so yay. I might as well show you the other combo. So this is the one that's actually on its way. I still have a decent amount to knit before I'm actually making any progress on this guy, but it probably needs a bag to contain everything because it is several small pieces. And hopefully I don't, like, run out of colors early or that sort of thing, because that would be great. And what was it? So I think the green is Vanna's Choice from the Turtle Cozy project, and I still need to block this bad boy. Alright, so this is all of the fade yarn hanging out in there. I've shown you guys that plenty of times. Alright, this guy. So I put, or whatever, actually my friend Lindsay ended up putting together this combo, so this is the white Vanna's Choice from the Turtle Cozy project, and then shades of blue and gray. Like, are we surprised? So, this might actually be from the original. I know I have, like, a little bit of my first knitting project hanging on my stash, but now I bet it's actually this blue. So And this is actually wool, I think, but whatever. It's probably not going to be the end of the world. So I have like a navy, this gray blue, this sort of variegated guy, and then the gray. So these will have very nice pop with the white acrylic. And then, this guy is a little bit of pink vomit. Like pink, I do believe the technical term was pink baby vomit. And so then I have this pink guy, I have this, this blue, purple, tealy green guy, and then I have two different shades of purple. One of these had been hanging out in the garage, for, you know, like when you put a ball up so you know how far to pull into the garage. This was in the garage, I think, in the apartment we were living in Indiana. So, that is a set. That's gonna be super girly. And then the last one is brown, and then I have this yellow, this red, and then I think more of this, what is it, this variegated guy. I swear I have like another one hanging out somewhere. Do I have like two of these balls and I've incorporated them into two projects? Oh no, they are different. So this one has a little bit more white in it than the other one. And then whatever leftovers I have from the green go into this too. So I think that will be very lovely. I think I used these three small balls in SSK hats that I did 2 years ago, the last time that I ended up going. So, and then these are just hanging out in different halves of the Joyity project bag. So I was super duper proud of Joyity this week. She graduated with her PhD in biomedical engineering. Yay! So we podcast together for a couple of months, and the podcast had been lost to the world because they were on blip. But I'm so proud of her. So she is one of the most impressive women I've ever met. So I am super glad. So she is now off to finish her last year of med school, because exactly, single most impressive woman I've met. So I have that, and then the other bag. So I might end up keeping this project in this bag, because I think all of these are different enough colors that it should be fine. But ulcers are fun there. So it has been a long time since I've made hats, because they're a lot of fun to make. I enjoy making them. I just don't set aside the time very often to do it. So now I'm like compacting all of the different things, organizing slightly. I have so much of this blue yarn left over, it's crazy. Like, I don't know if I need to incorporate it back on the other side of my fade, I don't even know. Because it is very molly blue, so good mid-range sort of color. But, I don't know. So that is all the knitting. The rest of the episode will be spent. Hey! And honestly, it may just be the lack of spinning, because, oh my gosh. So, I had something dreadful happen as I was winding my singles into a center pull ball for plying. I wasn't planning on plying it, because I can wait a week. for the beginning of Stash Desk to start that, but I needed a bobbin free, because all of my bobbins had stuff on it, and I don't know what it is about, like, these silk blends, but they just hold their shape. Like, this is totally the imprint of the ball winder, and it hasn't collapsed in at all. But this is my ball. This is all 4 ounces. Crazy makingly, but as I was winding it, I guess my hook mounted or whatever, I wasn't sliding my hook often enough, and I had a single break, and it was sort of deep within the bobbin. It wasn't actually winding, like, there was just something funny where yarn had, like, covered, whatever, other parts. And so wherever that end had broken off in, I have no clue where it was and what it was doing, because I never, I probably found it again, but I wouldn't have known which one was actually the end that broke. And I had one ridiculous, crazy, hell of a mess bobbin. I'm realizing now that I probably need to keep these ends close to each other. Because I'm probably going to be very sad if they do not remain close to each other. So we're just gonna contain them that way and crush this ball a little bit. So I lost my end. I tried finding a way to recover from this dreadful tragedy, but that was a big mess. So I had to end up breaking it a little bit so that I could wind parts off at a time, but it was a big mess. It was, and like when it did break, it was probably like an ounce and a half left on the bobbin, so I didn't want to lose that much yarn. So I struggled through it and I tied pieces on and tried to get sections which had like a smooth thing so that I could wind off for a while before it got trapped again. But it was pretty awful. But here are my singles and a center pull ball. The color sequence is a little bit crazy in spots because I had to just go wherever I had, what was it? I just had to go off of wherever in the world I actually had an end that I could pull stuff off of. The end probably has, the outside probably has a lot of grain, because when it broke it was on the grain, so I tried very, very hard to get that going. So I'm planning on applying it. I'll probably wait until after my ridiculous red spin is done, but I can see why people just decide to cut things off. The only saving grace is that finding the whatever, like getting the yarn off in a somewhat coherent way, like activated like puzzle solving Molly. So engineer brain was like, "Ooh, we're going to detangle this mess," but it was a pretty horrifying mess. I took a picture of the bobbin, I think, this morning when I still had a decent amount of detangling to do, but never want that to happen again, because that was pretty awful. And part of the problem is that sometimes I get lazy about moving the hook if I'm spinning while watching a movie, but that was bad. So hopefully this isn't a complete abject failure. There are an awful lot of tied on ends in this ball, but I'm hoping to hide it in the plying. Hopefully that works out. So this will probably sit for a little bit longer and we'll go from there. It just sticks out there for now. What's coming up next is the last bit of my jolly. And here is my triumphant empty bobbin with the leader tied back on. You know how bad it was? I actually searched out the leader and tried to pull it out, and a broken end came off. Crazy making. But, so I have 2 spun so far, and I have this 1 more third to go, and then my 8 ounces will be done. And I think the intention is to finish spinning this for the end of May, and I will have the right number of bin spins done, I believe. So, the alpaca silk was a diversion for my spin bin. And then I noticed that I had all of these samples done, and these were all my Judith McKenzie class samples, so they were sitting on my drying rack all nice and washed and thwacked and whatnot, and apparently I hadn't needed to do anything with them since. So this is a 2-ply with BFL that turned out really lovely and soft, and honestly I'm not quite sure where I'm gonna put everything now that it's done. And then this guy is the 3-ply with the same yarn, more or less. So very different the way that these guys ended up turning out. But overall, very nice, soft yarns. This was the the sweater yarn candidate, I do believe. So this is 3-plies spun sort of semi-woolen, then plied the bejesus out of it. And all of the different flecks are actually, silk and oil that had been put in there. So, like, I think I did a pretty, like, this is plied pretty tight. Normally, when I pull something like this out of the wash, it turns out to be super duper balanced, but this has quite a bit of ply twist to it, so that was cool. And then this last guy, oh, I see what that guy is. This guy is my cable yarn, for supposedly ridiculous socks with all of the different shades of blue and orange. Settled there. So, this is such a ridiculously vivid yarn. It doesn't even sort of like overloading my sensors when I look at it. But, I don't know. Colors are not turning out quite as vivid on the screen, which I find to be surprising. But, what is it? I think one of my BFL, or one of my BFL bin spins, I think will be along these lines, because I find it to be very interesting. So, I'll have to give that a shot. I'll probably have to spin the singles on the Ludicrous Ratio to get a, 4-ply fingering weight, but should be fun. What would it be? And then I get the have the fun of breaking up a braid into all of its component parts for spinning. So that tends to be entertaining. I'm just so bummed that it's not coming off on the camera as ridiculous as it is in real life. But oh, such is life. That is the challenge of recording here. I know, in some ways the light levels are a little bit better, but in other ways you're like, what was I doing? And then it's maybe a little bit improperly constrained. And then the last one I have sitting here is a chain ply of the leftovers from whatever my 2 and 3 plies, so same BFL. But it's not very much. It's hardly anything. So, it's just one maybe 2 yards. Of total yarn, but whatever. You can see its awkward chain plyness. So, I don't know. I really like how squishy this ended up turning out, so that entertains me. So, that's the problem with some of these samples, is that what in the world are you going to do with them now that the class is over and you have learned your things? But oh well, it's not the end of the world. It's just a little bit funny when you're like, okay, that was nice. Oops, lost that one. What are we gonna do now? Alright, I'm having a very hard time doing this today. It doesn't help that this is like quite the skein. Oh well. So I guess I will start bringing this down then, because that was everything that I wanted to talk about. But I decided, whatever. So, randomly, you get shown my samples from Judith McKinney's class again, because now they're washed. And that was interesting. I'm not bringing this down quite yet, because I did get a stash acquisition. So, my Nest Fiber Club came in this month, so the month of May was Falkland, because I am not in the luxury club. And the colorway is Blossom, and so this has pinks and a very olivey yellow, which is challenging my color sense, to be fair, and then purples and a little bit of teal as well, so very pretty. So I am curious about what in the world this yellow is going to do, because it's, I don't know, oftentimes gen stuff really goes together quite well, so I'm sure it'll be fine, but I was like, interesting. So this is another 4 ounces into the stash. I might need to be spinning slightly faster than spin the bin rate in order to properly do everything. I was like living super duper dangerous when I made this skein. Like, no ties. Let's see. So, that was interesting. That'll end up getting thrown into the stash. What would it be? So, I'm not sure what I'm going to. I don't know that I'm going to end up. So, one of my challenges is that trying to fit the SSK Cal into my knitting dance card, and then not necessarily being super duper inspired to. So, the hats were one way of sort of trying to fit into the SSK Cal appropriately, and whatever, so far so good on that front. So I did pull up a sock pattern that could do double 2D. The pattern is called Lamino. So right now in Sock Knitters we are doing a underappreciated pattern cal, where if the project has less than 50 projects since the beginning of May, and that the pattern had been published before February, because sometimes new patterns are that way, then that qualifies for the knit-along. And what is it? And then there's a certain amount of troubleshooting, because sometimes those patterns are... there's a reason why no one's knit them. But, what is it? But, whatever. P... FDA networked, maybe, has such a pattern that's for free, and a lot of her other pens are actually paid for, so I'm probably going to try, but I'm not sure I can work in an SSK yarn into that as well, because I'm not sure that I have any sock yarn that would qualify. Now there's yarn that I got from, or yarn that would be right for that. So I do have, say for example, some Sun Valley fibers, but it's super variegated, so I don't think that'll be a good choice for the pattern that I was thinking of. I have some Knitting Color, but that's still fiber. I'd have to spin that and then knit that, and I'm not even sure that would necessarily work out. Let's see, what I'm doing is trying to navigate to all of the vendors. So I'd have to spin my Ross Farm, I would have to spin my Knitting and Color, I don't have any With Me Stitches, Two Guys, Hopkins Sewing, Jinx, I'd have to spin the fiber, Fishnets, I don't own any, Gales Art, I don't have any Gales Art either, no Marigold John, Hobbling Boy, Hip Strings, Ticks, Twist Fear, Brick Fiber Studio, no Anchor Works, no Lollipop, no Fiber Seeds. I do have Sun Valley Fibers, but it wouldn't work for the pattern. I do have some Miss Babs, but not enough for a full pair of socks. No Bare Naked Wools, no Stranded Dye Works, no Fast Roll Fibers. I don't have a Jerry Brock spindle. I think I gave my Rock and String Studios stuff
away. I did have some.
At some point. Oh, no, I do have some Rock and String Studios, but that's an errand. And Tuft Woolens is soap, so I don't think I could wash it in the Tuft Woolens. And so, so that would be the case where, yes, I do have some of the stuff from these vendors already, but a lot of them, I don't, whatever. I'm a little sad because I might have been able to make something work with Mustache, but she's not going to be an SSK this year, so that's sad. So I don't get bonus points for that. And then what would it be? Oh, we do have Anna's PA Knitwit is the thing I'm going for. So it's like, I want to make it work, but it isn't quite working as you do. But I'll show you the pattern that I am thinking of. And then you will understand why it is that a really variegated yarn, I don't think, will do a good job. So it's sort of this mock cable thing going on. So, it is a cool pattern. I'm looking forward to doing it. But I'll have to pick a yarn that isn't on the list to do it, so sort of thing that, so that's gonna have to be sometime in the next 2 months. So I don't know if I will start it after I burn through all these hats, because hats count. They like double count because it's for the charity knitting and for the cows. Super fun. But I don't know. I certainly do have some solids in the stash. I probably. Oops, making things fly, or whether or not I just want to go ahead and start like a different project, like one of my sweater quantities or something. Anything to make a little more room. Seems like I'm sort of building up the self-striping, or it seems like everything, like, I want to knit solid socks and all I have is self-striping. Self-striping and faux aisle and whole bit. So or whether or not I just want to, I don't know, do something different. I'm not sure. Or just knit massive shawls over and over and over again. Since that has been so much fun lately. So, not sure. I should be able to record next week. That will be the 27th or the 28th. And if things go really crazy, it could even be the 29th. Who knows? We'll see whether or not I cast on anything else. I'm betting not. I bet I can work these hats and cereal. It should be fine. Yeah, I think that's it. So, with that, I hope you guys have a lovely week, and I look forward to talking to you guys next week. So, take care, guys. Bye-bye.